Hello everyone, welcome to Everything Arsenal and welcome to the match preview for Arsenal's Carabao Cup game against AFC Wimbledon. Back in the Carabao Cup once again, for the first time in very many years, we played in the second round. We managed to get a 6-0 win over West Brom that time. Very good performances from the likes of Aubameyang, scoring a hat-trick, Saka, Odegaard, all played very well in that match. But we are now in the third round and we are going to face League One Wimbledon. So we play the championship team and we're now going to play a League One team. So in this preview, I'm going to be taking a look at how Wimbledon have done so far this season. And I'm also going to be taking a look at, obviously, our lineup. What kind of lineup will we go for? It's going to be very interesting since we have Tottenham over the weekend. Obviously, the prediction at the end. I'm also going to be taking a look at the lineup we fielded against West Brom. What changes should he make? And obviously, I'm going to start by telling you how I feel about the Carabao Cup this season. Am I confident we'll win it? Should we win it? Should we be going full strength in this game? I'll be discussing all that. So make sure to smash the like button and make sure to subscribe on the road to 10,000. So let's get straight into it. AFC Wimbledon. Now, I can imagine not many of you know much about them. And just like me as well, I had to do some research on them. I think from the draw, if you're to ask me which team I would have wanted, I'd probably have mentioned Wimbledon amongst the five teams I would have wanted. Obviously, we usually are very unlucky in this competition. Like last season, we beat Liverpool and then we were given Leicester and then we beat Leicester and then we were given City. So Premier League teams away from home, all very, very hard games, although the City game was at home. This season, we've been given West Brom away from home, which could have been a tricky game because they were, I think, second on their table or top of the table. But luckily, they rested their players, which made it a bit easier for us. So how important is the Carabao Cup for me this season? 100% very important. Now, the other seasons, since the Wenger days, we used to see the likes of a young Jack Wilshere, a young Aaron Ramsey. We used to see the likes of Frimpong. We used to see the likes of, there was a goalkeeper called, I think it was Pom or something, if you guys can remember. I think it was called Pom or something like that. We used to play the likes of Ali Adia, Julio Baptiste in this competition. And I've been a fan of Arsenal since like 2003. And the only time I saw us being close to winning this competition, okay, twice. There's a time we played against Chelsea in the final back in 2007. We lost, obviously, to Drogba and the team. In 2011, we should have won it. Martin scoring in the last minute against us. And also, I think it was 2018 where we lost to City, which was very comfortable for City. So this time around, I wanted to be different. Obviously, everyone used to us winning the FA Cup, but this one is going to be a little bit different. Obviously, Liverpool are very strong, City are very strong. You can imagine all those teams trying to go for the FA Cup, Chelsea as well. Ronaldo at United, all of them would want trophies. So FA Cup would be probably a good cup for everyone, basically. Leicester also looking good in this competition last season. So any team can win it. Usually, I feel like the Carabao Cup, people usually, people normally underestimate it and they're like, you know what, we don't care about the Carabao Cup. But for us, we are not in any European competition, so we have to take this one seriously. We have to take it seriously. No other option. If we lose this game, for example, no midweek game until like January, which is not good for our reputation and all that. So we need put in a performance like we did against West Brom in the first game. Put in a performance, give a chance to a few players, yes. Score some goals, defend well, and we need to do all that. Speaking of defending well, Wimbledon are very good from set pieces. Wimbledon are very good from set pieces, and they score goals. Let's take a look at how they've done so far this season. 3 wins, 3 draws, and 2 losses in 8 games in their league. They've scored 15 goals and conceded 13. So there's a lot of games. There's been a 3-3. I saw there's been a 5-3. There's been a 3-2, a 2-2. So there's a lot of big, huge scores in their games this season. So they'll probably get a goal against us, but we definitely need to defend well, especially from set pieces. I had a Wimbledon fan talking, and I actually had them say they've scored the most set pieces in League One. So they have a defender who has scored 4 goals already this season. So I can only imagine a defender who has already scored 4 goals this season. We have just come from a test against Burnley, and we actually did pretty well against Burnley. And here comes another one against Wimbledon, another set piece examination for us. We need to do very well in terms of that. Wimbledon have done so far so well this season. They're currently, I think, seventh or eighth in their league. They got promoted to League One. They obviously used to play in League Two. And yeah, they're a very good team nowadays, as I said, scoring goals and all that. So we definitely need to watch them. Again, back to the importance of the Carabao Cup. I think the final is usually played in February. So I think if you win this competition, it automatically gives you like confidence for the rest of the season in the important stages of the season, March, April, May. If you win this competition, it gives you a lot of confidence heading into the tough games. Usually at that stage, we usually have like, I've said usually so many times in this video, right? Here I am again. Usually we play like Villarreal or Atletico Madrid, Marseille's in the Europa League, and no one is usually bothered about the Carabao Cup. At that stage, we're already out and stuff. But this season, we have to try and get something from it. It would be such a good thing for the likes of Sark and Smith to win another trophy. The new players, the likes of Lokonga and Tavares, to win a trophy. It would be very, very great for us to see those kind of players winning trophies. So in terms of which players should be rested and all that, I know I've said this competition is very important, but there are a few players I really need to be rested in this game. And one of them, obviously, is Thomas Partey. We have Tottenham over the weekend. Thomas Partey is very important to have in our team. I would definitely rest Thomas Partey. Tierney's the other one I'd definitely rest. I would not risk him at all. He went off with a kind of a knock, and I really need him in the derby, so I'd rest him as well. I'd also have to rest Saka. So those are three players I'd definitely rest. For the others, it could be anything. Obviously, I wouldn't mind if Aubameyang rested, if Pepe rested on any of those kind of players. I'd also try and rest Gabriel. Obviously, just came back from injury, and we really need him for the derby. He was magnificent against Burnley. So those are the four players I definitely rest. Thomas Partey, Tierney, Saka, and Gabriel. Those four players I definitely rest for the game. So before I go into my lineup for this game, let's take a look at the lineup we fielded last time out against West Brom. So this is how it looked against West Brom last time out. We started with Ramsdale in goal, obviously. Leno's still our fastest goalkeeper. We had Rob Holding and Kolasinac as the back two. We also had Tavares on the left, Chambers on the right, Xhaka and Elneny in midfield, Odegaard as the number 10, Saka, Pepe either side of Aubameyang. And on the bench, we started with Ramsdale. I always said Ramsdale. And on the bench, we had Leno. So Ramsdale is the one who started Leno on the bench. Pablo Mari, Niles, Lokonga, Smith-Rowe, Lacazette, and Martinelli also on the bench. So from that, Xhaka is still suspended, so he can't play. Elneny still kind of has a hamstring injury, so might not play. Kolasinac, I don't know what his situation is at the moment. Obviously, we could see Chambers holding Tavares. Ramsdale in goal is obviously been promoted almost to the first-choice goalkeeper. And Saka, I'm not sure if he's going to start. I really think he needs a rest. So this is how my lineup would look like for the Wimbledon game. I already put out a predicted lineup in terms of what I think Arteta would do. So I'll link it up in the YouTube right now if you want to check it out. So this is what I'd go for. Leno in goal. Although I just said Wimbledon are very good from set pieces, and I don't think Leno is the best. I think Ramsdale is better. I'd start with Leno for his confidence as well. He's not played for a couple of games, so I don't want him to be a bit raw on the bench and a bit rusty. You don't want that. So Pablo Mari and Holding at the back, Cedric and Tavares as the wing backs or the full backs, Niles and Lokonga in midfield, and then I'd change the formation to a 4-4-2. Yep, that allows us to have Pepe on the right, Martinelli on the left, and then Balogun and Lacazette up front. Lacazette also, I don't want him to be rusty. I know he's going to leave at the end of the season, but you still need a couple of his goals this season. Let's not forget about him. And for Martinelli, I was worried about him not playing any minutes at all. So we need him to play a few minutes here, or at least the whole game, basically. And Balogun, if he doesn't get a chance in this game, which other game will he play? Scored two goals over the weekend in the under-23s game against Chelsea, where we won 6-1. So that's the starting lineup I'd go for. Which means on the bench, Okonkwo, who was promoted early on this season, Gabriel, Chambers, Odegaard, Aubameyang, Ketia, and Charlie Patino. Charlie Patino, another one who was absolutely incredible, who has been absolutely incredible this season in the under-23s. He's only 17 years old, so I'm not sure he's going to make the bench anyway, but for me, I'd have him there. Give him some confidence alongside Balogun, obviously let them be on the bench. Another one I'd try is someone like Barrett. He scored a hat-trick against Chelsea over the weekend, but I think Balogun and Pochettino are slightly ahead of him. So those are the two I'd go for first. So that would be my starting lineup. And that leaves the prediction for the game. And I'm going to go for a 4-1 Arsenal win. I think we'll concede a goal. And for my goal scorers, I really don't know who's going to start. So I think Lacazette will bag a couple. So two goals for Lacazette, one for Martinelli, and probably one for maybe a Lokonga. First goal for Lokonga. That's what I'd go for. So 4-1. I think we'll concede maybe from a corner or something, or a counter-attack or something, because our defense would look a bit different. I've had some arguments about Ben White maybe starting because he missed a couple of games. Let us get him some confidence. I've heard about Ramsdale starting because of the set pieces that Wimbledon possess and stuff, set piece threats. So for me, that's what I'd go for. So let me know in the comment section what your prediction is. Let me know what your starting lineup would be. And as always, make sure to smash the like button. I'll really appreciate it. Check out the other videos. All the other videos are in the description that you can check out, that you should check out. So thank you for watching. Keep staying safe, and I'll catch up with you guys on the next one.